putting buildings at risk, which is frankly no mean feat. These efforts are continuing, and there is a willingness to work with a variety of partners, both public and private, as we've noted in the motion. Clearly, there is more work to be done, other venues to be focused upon, but let's not play down our successes. Addressing some of these buildings, many of them unused and some of them in poor condition, is not an easy thing to do. So some of the credits should go to our officers who deal with a multitude of people and a variety of situations and scenarios. We should be congratulated where there is success, and hopefully we will have more of it. And in this case, the government needs to recognise that because a city like ours, with the treasures that we have, we need our fair share. And as we know, this is a far too common occurrence. We need our fair share, whether that's financial assistance or credits where it's due. I would urge everybody to support this motion as is. Thank you very much.
Yes, answer the amendment by Councillor Ken. Would you like to move your amendment first, please?
Yes, thank you very much, Lord. I would like to congratulate Councillor Norris, not only on the resolution, which I largely agree with, but also the spirit with which he believes passionately in the urban form of Liverpool, in the buildings here which make our city unique. Some members might find it hard to think, but I used to be a young councillor myself, younger even than Councillor Norris. And I remember the first time I ever voted against my group, when this council, and I lost, so this council voted unanimously on this, apart from five of us, to demolish the Lyceum. That building is still there. I think there's some things that might mean that the Lyceum is coming into life again, but we kept it. And the second time I voted against my group was to preserve the Georgian buildings on Upper Parliament Street, which for the last 40 years have actually been good homes, but not only good homes, but homes that say something about Liverpool on a very important street in our city, which tens of thousands of people go across every day. So, when we get visitors to Liverpool, and I'm sure every member of this council does, I give them all a fact. And it's a fact that amazes them, but you'll know, and that fact is that this city has more listed buildings than any city in the country outside London. And preserving them isn't easy, which is why I welcome the buildings that have been preserved here. They've been built for a different purpose, in a different way, in a different time, and finding new uses isn't easy. And everyone that we save, everyone that we bring back into use, preserves the uniqueness of our city and makes it a place that people want to visit. But where I do believe that we need to add to this motion is in two ways. And I apologise to members of the planning committee who have heard me say this on many occasions, but I'm appalled at some of the stuff we are allowing to be built in our city. Low grade, low quality stuff, and it doesn't have to be this way. At the last meeting before Christmas, it occurred to me that every time a group of architects called Block put in a planning application, I get very enthusiastic about it. Really good stuff, really good.
the record, does this amendment seconded? Councillor Batchelor.
Recovery from his the illness he's been he's been suffering from. Now, I have no doubt that the pressure of work that council officers are under in the financial situation that we're in at the moment and the current work demands that are put on them is having an impact on people's health as we move forward. My heritage officers in the Regeneration Directorate and the Regeneration Directorate officers anyway work amazingly hard and are under a lot of pressure and achieve amazing results. The reliance, I don't want to criticise anybody beyond the criticism I've made there, but rather to recognise the great assistance we get from those officers, to recognise the great assistance we get from English Heritage, Historic England and the Heritage Lobby. I look there at the Mayor's here, the absolute commitment of the Mayor to the heritage of this city. We do have a great challenge. The one thing that is missing in the current financial situation that was more present, say 10, 15 years ago, is there is now no ability to do gap funding. We need to, we have